Hey guys, Simonelli here. Today, we learn how to send materials from Substance Painter to Blender, so let's get started. We'll begin by learning how to configure the plugin for Blender. The plugin has five main sections: connection, output, additional maps, depth, and texture sets. Seems like a lot, but in reality it's pretty simple and straightforward. In connection, you'll define the software, the renderer, and the preset. The software is the third application you want to use alongside Substance Painter, in this case, Blender. In Renderer, at the moment you can select Octane or Cycle Eevee. I'll try to add V-Ray as soon as 2.8 version is released. For this example, we'll select Cycle Eevee. And in Preset, you select the type of shading network you want to create for the renderer. For Cycle Eevee, by default there are two options, Standard and Standard Packed. The difference is that Packed mixes the metallic and roughness maps in a single file. Metallic in the red channel, and roughness in the green channel. There are ways to create more presets if you need other complex networks, but that will be covered in another video. So let's select Standard. The next section is Output. The first parameter is the output path. This is the place where you want the files to be exported. The default value is the default export path of Substance Painter. But you can use the Browse button to change and select a different path, and the folder button to open the selected path in the System Explorer. Then we have two subsections, Maps and Mesh. We'll explain the Mesh section in detail in another video. Now, for the Maps subsection, there are only two parameters, Resolution and Format, which basically define the resolution and the format of the final export. We'll leave the default values of 1K and PNG. Next, we have the Additional Map section. Here, we have the option to add to the selected preset some extra maps that are not included by default: height, opacity, emissive, subsurface scattering, and anisotropy. Unlike the maps included in the preset, these ones are not essential to define a PBR material. That is the reason they are optional. And for these maps to work, you need to have the respective channel available in the texture set definition, as you can see here. For this example, I'll add only the emissive map. Now we have the depth section. It's common for artists to want to use different bit depths depending on the type of maps. For example, maps like normal, height, and anisotropy angle benefit a lot by having 16 or more bit depth to avoid stair-stepping values. You can learn more about it in this video. The link will be added to the description. Because of that, I added the possibility of setting the depth independently. Main defines the depth of the basic PBR maps, base color, roughness, and metallic, and the other ones define their respective maps bit depth. I'll set the normal depth to 16. Finally, the last section is texture sets. In this section, you'll define which elements of the project you want to export: mesh, texture sets, and hopefully soon even environment maps. The first thing you need to do in this section is to click Load every time you open a Painter project. That will show the list of texture sets and the mesh of the project. Once the list is loaded, you can use the auxiliary buttons All, Known, and Textures to quickly select what you want to export. Also, you can directly enable items in the list. Now, with everything configured, we are ready to start using the plugin. First, we need to make Blender releases to Substance Painter. So we open Blender and click Start Server. We go back to Painter, and after selecting the items on the list, two buttons will be enabled: Create and Refresh. Let's see what each button does. Create will create the materials in the scene from scratch. If there is already a material with the same name as the texture set, it will delete it first before creating it. This will be always the first step to send materials to Blender. Refresh on the other side will only ensure the reload of textures. This is helpful especially if for some reason after creating a material, you made a specific change in the shader network, like adding an additional node or changing a value. By clicking Refresh, you won't lose those changes. Always remember that Refresh will only work after clicking Create at least once.